boys and girls, and welcome to St. Marguerite de Vel Children's Liturgy. My name is Bernadetta, and today we will be reading from John's Gospel. Jesus showed himself again to the disciples by the Sea of Tiberias, and he showed himself in this way. Gathered there together were Simon Peter, Thomas called the Twin, Nathanael of Cana in Galilee, the sons of Zebedee, and two others of his disciples. Simon Peter said to them, "I am going fishing." They said to him, "We will go with you." They went out and got into the boat, but that night they caught nothing. Just after daybreak, Jesus stood on the beach, but the disciples did not know that it was Jesus. Jesus said to them, "Children, you have no fish, have you?" They answered him, "No." He said to them, "Cast the net to the right side of the boat, and you will find some." So they cast it, and now they were not able to haul it in because there were so many fish. That disciple whom Jesus loved said to Peter, "It is the Lord." When Simon Peter heard that it was the Lord, he put on some clothes, for he was naked, and jumped into the sea. But the other disciples came in the boat, dragging the net full of fish, for they were not far from the land, only about 90 meters off. When they had gone ashore, they saw a charcoal fire there with fish on it and bread. Jesus said to them, "Bring some of the fish that you have just caught." So Simon Peter went abroad and hauled the net ashore, full of large fish, 153 of them. And though there were so many, the net was not torn. Jesus said to them, "Come and have breakfast." Now none of the disciples dared to ask him, "Who are you?" because they knew it was the Lord. Jesus came and took the bread and gave it to them, and did the same with the fish. This was now the third time that Jesus appeared to the disciples after he was risen from the dead. When they had finished breakfast, Jesus said to Simon Peter, "Simon, son of John, do you love me more than these?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my lambs." A second time he said to him, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" He said to him, "Yes, Lord, you know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Tend my sheep." He said to him the third time, "Simon, son of John, do you love me?" Peter felt hurt because he said to him the third time, "Do you love me?" And he said to him, "Lord, you know everything. You know that I love you." Jesus said to him, "Feed my sheep. Very truly, I tell you, when you were younger, you used to fasten your own belt and go wherever you wished. But when you grow old, you will stretch out your hands and someone else will fasten a belt around you and take you where you do not wish to go." He said this to indicate the kind of death by which he would glorify God. After this, he said to him, "Follow me." This scripture passage talks about a time after Jesus had died and resurrected. He was gone, but he kept appearing to his disciples here and there, and this was the third time he had done so. So the disciples did recognize him after the few things that Jesus did that he did while he was living. Remember, when Jesus was doing his ministry, he was being an example to the disciples and teaching them how to be in the world. So only through his actions were they able to recognize him, and through the words that he was saying. But then he tested Simon Peter and asked him three times the same question. Imagine being asked three times the same question and having to answer it the same every time. It's kind of confusing, isn't it? But Jesus was testing him, because through our life, we will always get tested and we will always be asked to make the right choices and say the right things, even if we have to repeat ourselves. If you think of a time when this happens at home, maybe your mom or dad or a family member, they ask you repeatedly to do something. And the first time it's like, yeah, yeah, I'll get to it. The next time is like, I'm going, I'm going. The third time, it's like you get asked and you're frustrated that you're being asked, but you're trying to finish off something. Think of those times. And maybe if we were a little bit more conscious and actually believed in what we were even saying as well, then maybe our words would have more meaning. We have to be more conscious of the things we say and act upon the things we say, maybe a little bit quicker. Jesus asking Simon three times, maybe it was to help him recognize in himself what he was actually saying. Jesus asked, "Do you love me?" And Simon said, "You know I love you." But he wasn't actually thinking about the words that he was saying. He needed to repeat himself three times to actually believe the words that he was saying. Can you think of times when you need to repeat to yourself, to motivate yourself, to believe the things that you are actually saying? This happens a lot in life where we have to do affirmations of things that we believe in. God may know what's in your heart, but sometimes you need that repetition to know what's in your own heart. So let's say a prayer together and pray that we recognize the goodness in ourselves and the love that God has for us and the plans that God has for us. And we'll say a Hail Mary together. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Have a blessed week, boys and girls, and may you recognize in yourself what God recognizes in you every day. Bye. See you next time.